Okay, sir.
Okay. So yeah, you can just discuss with him.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
You are in Bhopal, no?
No, sir. Delhi. IG Stadium, Delhi.
Okay. Captain Bahel is there, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Bhaskar. For Monday, Kavita has strength training.
No, sir. So, tomorrow is there, no, sir? Saturday.
Oh, who's doing tomorrow?
Huh?
Who's doing tomorrow?
Kavita, madam, sir. Strength and conditioning.
Okay, just substitute with Namrata.
Tomorrow's Namrata, madam, sir.
Just call her and I speak to her.
Okay, sir. Same timing, sir, 2:30?
2:30, yeah, same.
Okay, sir.
Harmanveer, did you try out that Smarta Base athletic management system?
I have not, sir, yet. I had 3 sessions before this. One was budget and we had orientation and one other class. So after this one, I'll try, sir.
You just go through that. Okay, see the modules. Okay, how best we can go for planning training sessions and documentation of things like RP and so on. So there are actually so many modules in this. We cannot enter any data, but then what is there in it, and based on that you can just explore. And then when we are preparing a dashboard for this, we have to custom. But just so switch on your video also so the people can see you, you know.
Sir, due to slow internet, I am switching it off. After presentation, I will on it. Okay, sir? Today, we are going to discuss on somatotype. That is, know your body. Before jumping into the main discussion, I would like to show you something to think first. Sitting in the field of sports, we are all familiar with all these faces and their wonderful achievement and accomplishment. They are all unique in their field. But if you think about their body form, that was so different from one another. Here lies the question, which body form is suitable for specific kind of sports, or what kind of body is required for any particular sports? In mind, today's presentation or discussion is a small attempt to explore the actual. So, starting with the definition, somatotype is defined as the quantification of present shape and composition of human body. Or we can also say that somatotype is a method for describing the human physique in terms of a number of traits that relate to the body shape and composition. Before going further, let be familiar with those who made the significant contribution in this field. Today's commonly used term somatotype was first introduced by Sheldon in his book The Varieties of Human Physique, who was an American psychologist and a renowned physician. In Sheldon's method, an attempt is made to describe the genotypical morphological trait of a person in 3-point component, each on 7-point scale. But later, that was criticized by several other scholars, and a new method emerged, which was created by Heath and Carter in 1990. Now, Heath was a well-known physical anthropologist and one of the world's leading authorities on somatotype method. And knowing about Carter, who served as a faculty member of Otago University and San Diego State University, his research work was mainly focused on athletes and non-athletes. He was a key investigator in anthropometric studies of Olympic and World Championship athletes. He was also a past president of International Society for Advancement of Kinanthropometry. He was also a fellow of American Academy of Kinesiology and Physical Education and a member of American College of Sports Medicine. And Heath Carter's somatotype method is universally applied method. Now, moving to the next slide. The somatotype rating expressed in 3-number rating system, that is endomorphy, that is amount of fat in the body, mesomorphy, that is amount of muscularity or musculoskeletal robustness of the body, and ectomorphy, that is linearity or slenderness of the body. Every human body have. Now, for example, this rating comes always in this fashion: endomorphy, mesomorphy, and ectomorphy. Here I would like to give you an example that 3-5-2. The rating is for endomorphy 3, mesomorphy 5, and ectomorphy 2. Those who know somatotype, after knowing somatotype with this number, you can easily imagine or visualize the body type of a person. For example, here the mesomorphic or mesomorphy rating is high. So from these numbers, you can easily visualize that person is with heavy masculinity than other two components. Apart from this, there are some other examples like, this rating comes, the relative meaning of the rating we need to know first, that is 0.5 to 2.5 represent very low, 3.3 to 5 represent moderate value, 5.5 to 10 represent high value, and 7.5 and above represent very high value. Now, these are some other somatotype categories. If you see the first one, the 444 or 222. In this example, a person is identified with equal amount of muscle, fat, and linearity in their body, so that he or she may be identified in the central type. For another example, if you see the third one, 5-3-2, that means that person have a higher amount of fat in their body, then muscularity in their body, and then slenderness in the body. That person will be identified as mesomorphic, endomorphic. For another example, if you come to the last one, 6-2-3, you can see that the endomorphic value is high, then ectomorphic value, and then mesomorphic value. Then the two value, first one and last one, is highest. So according to that, there they come under ectomorphic, endomorphic categories. Now, after understanding this, we need to know that what are the methods for identifying somatotype. There are three ways of obtaining somatotype. anthropometric method, photoscopic method, and both anthropometric plus photoscopic method. In anthropometric method, which is accepted all over the world and valid for all population, and it is used for those who have similar development for whole body. Next is photoscopic method. It is a bit difficult one. Here, height weight chart is used after taking photographs at frontal view, from back and lateral view. This method is specially used for those who are visible. And in last method, anthropometric and photoscopic both are used to understand the somatotype any person. Today's discussion is only focused on anthropometric method. In anthropometric somatotype method, we need total of 10 measurements: height, weight for skin fold, tricep, subscapula, supraspinale, and calf measurement. For breadth measurement at humerus and femur, and for girth measurement at upper arm circumference at flex condition and calf measurement. For taking this measurement, we need some specific instruments. These are: a stadiometer is used for taking height, a weighing scale is used for taking body weight, a skin fold caliper is used for taking tricep, subscapula, supraspinale, and medial calf. A flexible tape is used to measure mid upper arm circumference and calf circumference. A sliding caliper is used for taking femur breadth and humerus breadth. Now we have taken all the measurements. Now our next step is to use this Heath Carter somatotype rating chart. This is conventionally used for identifying endomorph, mesomorph, and ectomorphic value. And we have with us those 10 measurements, putting those measurements here and calculating those values, you will get these values. Another way of calculating these values are with this equation. You can use this equation and put your values here to get endomorphic value, mesomorphic value, and ectomorphic value. So we have identified endomorphic, mesomorphic, ectomorphic value. Now, next step is to plot these values to identify your actual position. So we need a 2D somatotype chart. See, this is mesomorphic, this is ectomorphic, and this is endomorphic, this is ectomorphic. This area represents endomorphic position, this area represents endomorphic, and this area represents ectomorphic. And in between that area represents mesomorphic and ectomorphic component. This area represents mesomorphic and endomorphic component, and this area represents endomorphic ectomorphic position. Now, to plot your position in this chart, you need to calculate a x value and y value. So how to calculate the x and y? With this equation, you can put your ectomorphic, endomorphic, mesomorphic value and get the x and y value. Then plot your position in this chart so that you can identify where are you at present. For example, those who are suffering in obesity and obesity related diseases, for example, he may be identified his position here. And now he is under any treatment, medication, exercise, diet, means help from or support from different departments can help her or him to change her position from here to here, or the desired body composition he or she squared. For another example, for a sportsman. A sportsman is identified his or her position here. For example, during lockdown, during corona, he or she was not able to do exercises and her body shape changes. And he or she is now in a position where he or she needs to change her body type according to the need of that sports and the performance. Here also he or she required the help of his coach, strength and conditioning expert, and nutritionist for proper guidance. With this proper guidance, he can change or shift her or his position from one place to another. For more clear understanding, I want to give some other examples. Like, this is an example for elite boxers. A study on elite boxers and non-athletes. See, most of them are distributed in mesomorphic component area. And if you see the non-athletes, they are distributed throughout the graph in a scattered way. And if we identify the result of that study, which shows that for endomorphic components, boxer were lower than non-athletes. That is obvious. They are in a proper training, proper exercise. So their fat component is lower, muscle component is higher. For mesomorphic component, boxers were higher than non-athletes. That is also obvious. Their muscle is more strong and high compared to non-athletes. And their ectomorphic value is almost similar. Now, for another example, this is a study on swimmers and table tennis players. See, greater mesomorphic component in swimmer than table tennis players. And swimmers and table tennis players were more endomorphic in average. And if we compare male and female, females are more endomorphic than their counterpart or the male players. And because we know that females and males body composition is different and fat component in female is higher compared to male. Now, for another example, this is a old study on Nigerian males from different background of sports, where you can see that judo players and hockey players are mostly identified in mesomorphic endomorph component area. And other category of sports, badminton, basketball, handball, and soccer, were identified in mesomorphic ectomorphic area. So from this, we try to understand the utility and usefulness of understanding your body, or usefulness of somatotype in a sports field, and it's also usefulness in health and wellness. So in conclusion, it can be said that somatotype rating has a very positive role in selecting prospective athletes for different sports. Apart from sports, somatotype can also be used in wider fields, such as changes in physique with age, occupational differences, geographical and ethnic difference. But there have some limitation that for minute detailing, there is a need to measure by a qualified measurer. Otherwise, there is a heavy chance of error. And it is also dependent on instrument use. So with this, I would like to end with that. Knowing your body can help you to assess your health and fitness level. Thank you all of you for your patience and participation. Thank you so much.
Oh, can you put the slide on table tennis and swimmers?
Yes, sir.
This is Nigerian team, not table tennis.
Yes, sir.
Put the slide on table tennis and swimmers.
Yeah, sir.
See, now junior swimmers, male 20 and female 6. Whereas in the tennis players, you have male 15 and female 14.
Yes. The number of players, sir.
So, and you said that, okay, females have higher,
Sir, last one. The females were identified more endomorphic. See, the position 2 and 4. They are near to endomorphic position.
Okay,
and compared to 1 and 3, they are male.
Okay.
So that's why I'm saying that their person body fat is higher naturally compared to male. That's why I'm saying, sir.
Okay. Why you're comparing between swimmers and table tennis player? What's
sir, it? I'm not comparing, sir. This is a study by Nandi et al. In 2016.
Okay.
Those who compared this, and I have just give this example to show you this so that I can explain you better.
Fine. So when you're actually presenting this now, you please quote who was even the author of the study and
yes, which, sir.
You know, all the, those things you put it in the maybe in the what do you call footer of this slide, okay, so that at least people can if they want to take some notes on this, it will be good. Same way for the Nigerian study also.
Yeah.
Putting it here. So any it would be good if you can put it as footnotes or something.
Okay.
All right. Any questions? You can just unmute and ask questions.
Sir, this is Mary speaking. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, Mary.
Madam Priyanka, you have said about all the games which was like team event and individual games. I want to know about weight category events, because we belongs from, yeah, please.
Sir, ma'am, I know that you want to know about the taekwondo,
yeah.
I think. According to a little bit research on that, there are two, that means I understand two things, that according to different weight categories, you need to put your means athlete on endo and ecto, if you understand this.
I did not understand much, but
okay.
I have got many ideas today.
Okay.
I'm trying to
answer your question. That is mesomorphic position, that is endomorphic position. Okay.
No, I got it, but I just want to know ki mujhe kaise pata chalega kaun sa, jaise ek hai jo competition normally hote hain, there are total 8 weight categories in male and then female, so unme mujhe pata chahiye ki kaun sa bachcha kaun si body ke liye suitable hoga, agar koi ek body hai to wo kaun si category ke liye acha hoga, kyunki Indian athlete zyada tar fatty hote hain, so definitely they'll fall in heavier side. तो वही मैं जानना चाह रही थी।
अच्छा, तो इसके लिए मैम पहले मैं ये बताना चाहती हूँ, जेनेटिकली एवरी पर्सन इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर, तो अब आप उन मतलब किसी बच्चे का मतलब वेट मतलब पोजीशन इन सोमाटो चार्ट मतलब जानने के बाद, अगर आप देखें कि उसका वेट कैटेगरी वाइज वो कैसा परफॉर्म कर रहा है, ठीक है, अगर उसके वाइज उसका परफॉर्मेंस आप जितना चाह रहे उतना तक नहीं हो रहा है, तब आपको शिफ्ट करवाना पड़ेगा एक पोजीशन से दूसरे पोजीशन तक। तो ये थोड़ा एक्सपेरिमेंटल है, क्योंकि अभी दूसरे स्टडी वाइज फॉर एग्जांपल आप अगर कोई इंटरनेशनल स्टडी इंटरनेशनल जूडो सॉरी ताइक्वांडो एथलीट के साथ अपने हमारे इधर के बच्चों को कंपेयर करेंगे कि उसका अभी इतना ये परफॉर्मेंस है, उसका ये वेट कैटेगरी है, अभी तुम्हें वही ऐसा ही होना है, ठीक है? ऐसा नहीं बोल सकते. उसका परफॉर्मेंस हम लोग देख के उसके वाइज हम उसको ट्रेनिंग देके उनको कितना चेंज करवाना है ये कर सकते हैं मैडम. ये एक्चुअली ये केस वाइज, केस टू केस वाइज वेरी करता है. मतलब एक के साथ दूसरे का मतलब सेम सेम होगा कि कंपेयर ऐसा नहीं हो सकता अकॉर्डिंग टू माई नॉलेज मैम.
ओके ओके ओके, थैंक यू. आप तो यही है, वी विल कम टू यू एंड वी विल डिस्कस. थैंक यू सो मच.
Yes. Anyone else?
Sir, may I add with your permission before I get into my course program, sir?
Yes, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. This is something very important area as far as weight category is concerned, and we have a lot many things to do together, Priyanka, because we have test our athletes and see that which athlete falls in which weight category. And ये अच्छा है जो आपने अभी दिखाया. तो हमारे एथलीट्स को ये नॉलेज होना चाहिए कि हमारे लिए सुटेबल कौन सा वेट कैटेगरी है. मेनी ऑफ द एथलीट्स दे गेट इन टू वेट रिडक्शन बाई गोइंग जस्ट कटिंग डाउन द लीन बॉडी मास. फाइनली दे लैंड अप इन, आई हैव सीन प्रैक्टिकली दे रिड्यूस सो मच ऑफ बॉडी वेट. After going there, they cannot play a single round properly. So, now just giving up a few, examples. Started in last pandemic for our athlete Rodali Barua, she was almost 86. And then we did every Monday with the help of kind support of Dr. Athuni, we could get the body composition done every Monday. And the training program was made in such a way that okay, she will reduce the only the fat mass. And then with the advice of our HPD, segmental cutting of fat was also, because she will be carrying extra poundage to do kicking. Then that was also discussed very closely with Dr. Athuni and some of the doctors, those who have already worked inside. So now we are into that, and definitely this whole study, it will help not only taekwondo, all the coaches, whichever area, whichever segment is carrying extra poundage, we have to work segmentally for that, and it will help in overall performance. Thank you.
I have a question, sir, if I may.
Yeah, please.
What sort of studies are you doing right now with your athletes? Because I'd like to know if we can find like a spot on this chart that says, okay, if for example I'm training cyclists, like we could say, okay, this point in this chart is the best body composition for male cyclists and female cyclists, and so I think that would help if that sort of study could be conducted, because then I'll know where their body composition stands at the moment and what changes I need to make and how much changes I can make before their performance starts going down or up, if you understand what I meant by that.
Actually, what I understand from your question, that my suggestion is to first see their performance level on the weight category or the body composition they have present, and after judging that, you have to plan it accordingly to enhance her or his performance. It will be helpful more, because without understanding present condition, you cannot change his or her body composition and other required things which will help him or her to increase or for a better performance.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, can I add into this? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible. Ma'am.
Okay, actually, Priyanka, just this thing of what Sajusa was asking, actually, he was referring to the sample size, because you need at least a minimum sample size of 30 in order to make a comparison, statistical comparison. Okay. So I think sir was referring to that one, if I'm not mistaken. So, and then when we are referring to somatotype type here, we are trying to create a profile of the athlete, that is a body type. Say, for example, when I say a square, you can actually visualize what it looks like, right? So similarly, when we are looking at somatotype type here, we are trying to actually define the body type. We do on sedentary population also, as well as for the athlete. So you can make a comparison of the athlete, like exactly what body type they are in. And the chart actually, which she had shown actually, that is the somato chart, where you can track actually the profile of an athlete. You can track the progress as per the training plan, which you have implemented also. And then, is it Haramveer or am I?
Harmanveer, yes, ma'am.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, responding to the question actually which you have put up, in that case, actually, you can refer to the segmental body composition analysis. Say, for example, you can, what I mean to say is like you can take the help of an anthropometrist there if you have got a body composition analyzer and do the segmental body composition analysis where you can get a clear idea of like how much fat area is there in the upper arm and the muscle area. Similarly for the leg also. If you have got any specific training plan which you have implemented on the athlete and to see like if you want to track whether it's working or not.
Yes, that is what I had in mind. So
exactly.
I think that would be done by the skinfold caliper, if I'm not wrong.
A skinfold caliper, you can just get an overall like body composition, like how much of body fat percentage and muscles. Uh-huh. But if you want to go for specific thing.
I lost you. I think you got cut off.
Am I audible?
Yeah. Now you're audible.
Okay. So if you're going for segmental analysis, for example, you have the upper arm, right?
Right.
You have got the right side and the left side.
Yep.
So each side, you can, if you go for the segmental body composition analysis with the help of a multi-frequency body composition analyzer, okay, uh-huh. But you have to make sure that the room temperature and the humidity are controlled. And the athlete has to follow certain procedure and the test has to be conducted at a specific time only. So, if the athlete followed your procedure or not, because we've already conducted the experiment here, okay? So uh-huh. What this multi-frequency body composition analyzer does is, it will give you a value of the segmental body composition analysis, that is in the upper arm, the right and the left side, how much of fat area is there also, as well as how much of muscle area is also there. So you can track the progress of an athlete that way. And if there's any sort of imbalances also, you can actually in terms of quantitative, if you want to check, you can check it that way also.
Yes, that would be helpful. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
May I add something to what earlier added by ma'am? And it is about NCA cyclist athletes, basically.
Yeah, please.
Ashwani.
Yes, ma'am. This is Ashwani this side. And my senior, Miss Alisha, actually worked with one of my other senior physiologists, Miss Jyotsna Agarwala. And both of them actually conducted a study about morphophysiological features of NCA cyclist. And that study was conducted in 2018, basically. So that study found out about the cyclists that we had at NCI during that period. And about 29 athletes were assessed. And their body somatotype came out to be mesomorphic ectomorph for most of them. Just a few came around to the mesomorphic endo section. And those were sprinters, as much as I understand, who came into the mesomorphic endomorph section. And others were distance cyclists who came in mesomorphic and ectomorph section. Plus their VO2 max and heart rate were also assessed. I could forward the study later on if Herman Weir required that.
Oh yeah, thank you. That would be helpful. I'll look into it.
Yeah, anyone else?
Sir, actually, I would like to add.
Any other questions?
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay, one thing which I would like to add is, like, if you're dealing with high performance athlete, I would definitely recommend going for body composition analysis only, because in cyclists, I think you have, there will be a bit of like balance, there will be slightly unbalanced because the lower body actually in terms of like, especially the thigh, the circumference definitely will be more. I think Sadhu sir has done research, most of the research on the cyclists when in his previous, where he was posted previously. So he has actually shared some of his research work also then. So it's better actually that you go for body composition analysis if you are planning, I mean, if you're assessing on a high performance athlete.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Continue. I couldn't hear what Dr. Tony was saying. Yeah, no problem. Because there's a lot of disturbance in network here. Hello. Continue.
Priyanka, I think you can move to the next question because SAR's network is not okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyone want to know anything about you, about this? If no one, then I would like to invite some of my anthropometrist colleagues who are present here. If you like to add something to the somatotyping method or which I have missed, or any idea you want to share. Arun? Hello, Arun? Arun Kumar, Dr. Arun Kumar, are you there? Hello? Arun?
Yeah, he's there, but I think his video and audio are muted.
Okay. Debarathi, are you there?
Yes, Devaruti, I am here.
Devaruti, you are, as you are also working on anthropometric same field in LAP, if you like to add anything for regarding this force field and its use, somatotype methods use and application, if you like to add anything.
Actually, from my side, we can add the body fat percentage part with this somatotype. Then only it will conclude one thing. And including that, I think here some limitations we have, because we don't have the nationwide database. So we don't have the knowledge that where to go by somatotype. But we can do one thing, by gathering the data from the athlete who are going to Olympics. So from here, there, we can conclude something. Priyankadi, please.
That is a good suggestion, actually. Thank you. And any other anthropometrist from any other centers who can add something on this?
Can I say something?
Yes, please.
Good afternoon, everybody. This is Dr. Harshdeep Singh Ganjal. I'm posted in NCOE Jagratpur, Cuttack. Thank you, Dr. Priyanka, for a wonderful presentation for relating somatotype with few athletics. I want to say that not only few, but there are much games with which we have to relate the anthropometry, the somatotype, in a very deep manner. Because every sports has its own specification. Every sports has its own different kind of athletes. So not a single presentation is sufficient for us to elaborate each and everything for every sports. It is quite challenging when you summarize the presentation in a very short manner and try to relate it with few sports. The meaning to say is, the work for we anthropometrists especially is a bit challenging, because as Devaruti madam said, that it is very difficult for our country because we are in devoid of database.
Yeah.
We are in devoid of the standardizations of certain anthropometric measurements. सबसे पहले हमारा काम होगा कि हम इस एरिया में ये काम करें कि हमें अपने एंटायर स्पोर्ट्स पीपल का डेटा रेडी कैसे करना है, ताकि वो एक स्टैंडर्डाइज हो करके अदर नेशंस के साथ कंपेयर हो सके. देन ओनली वी विल कम टू द स्टेप कि हम किसी पर्टिकुलर स्पोर्ट को एंथ्रोपोमेट्री के साथ में या फिर सोमेटोटाइप के साथ में हम कैसे रिलेट कर पाते. इट इज गोइंग टू टेक फ्यू मंथ्स. A couple of months will be needed for all of us.
Yeah.
So this is my input, and I personally, from my side, is always ready for doing such kind of work. Ki ab hum sabko mil ke is area mein mehnat karna hoga, because for the very first time we are thankful to Sai ki pehli baar itne huge number of anthropometrists ko include kiya gaya, jo ki pehle se hi other nations mein chalta aa raha hai.
Yeah.
History is evident of this. To abhi okay. India mein humko ye chance mila.
Okay, see, Mr. Ganjal, if you actually look into, see, there has been anthropometry in Sai from somewhere around 1987 onwards. Okay,
sir.
There are a lot of data.
Sir, I think network from your side is a bit congesting. That is not allowing you to speak properly.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir, is not audible.
Yes.
Hello.
Sir.
Can I speak, sir, something? This is Dr. Arun Kumar.
Yes, please. Arun, please.
Yes, sir. Myself is Dr. Arun Kumar, as an anthropometrist from NCO Bhopal. We are preferring somatotyping also. Also, we prefer anthropometric measurement with international and national data, just like to the CDC, Center for Disease Control, already work on the sports person. And same with the FitGram is a one agency to work on the sports athletes. So they particularly work for the particular ages and particularly sports to activities for the different measurements. So we can also use their comparatively analysis to justify whether the person is a perfect actually age parameter or not. So we can also use this type of anthropometric measurement to analyze the our sports person is up to the mark, standard level or national level. So we can also add on this to the parameter. So also we also use the body composition analyzer. Body composition analyzer not only for the anthropometric measurement. It's also provided water contaminancy, body fat, muscle fat. So different sports not needed to bulky fatting. So sometimes they need the muscle mass, not to just show off the obesity. So we can these are the parameter helpful to reducing the our obesity to in the muscular mass skeleton to increase the muscular mass. So this type of activities in best for the our weightlifting activities, and we also needed to sometime low weight for the athletes like to the sprinters. So they not needed to more fatty, but they also needed the more energy, more body weight. Strength. So they need to at least energy. So at least they for energy they required a more muscle mass. So this type of activities we can continuously with anthropometric measurement use, and we continuously just measuring the candidates as a national and standard parameter. So it's helpful to all the parameters for the so reducing and increasing the weight, and particularly the game to game and activity to activity, with the help of the nutritionists and the strength and conditioning officers. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Arun. This is a good suggestion.
Hello. Yeah. Yes, sir, ma'am.
Okay.
I think there is a network issue, sir.
Yeah.
Dr. Arun?
Ma'am?
Okay, am I audible?
Yeah, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dr. Arun जो बोल रहे थे, we can देखो एक चीज तो ये देखना है कि when it comes to sports हम लोग को individually देखना होता है athlete को. हम एक range race करते हैं, लेकिन उस athlete का जो होता है उसका optimum अलग होता है दूसरे से, उसके opponent से भी अलग होता है, तो वो भी consider करना होगा हम लोग. This is actually from my the personal experience, like through the assessment I've done over the years with the athletes. Ultimately, ये होता है हम लोग को athlete को individually assess करना है, उसका optimum range होगा वो अलग होगा दूसरे से, उसके opponent से. क्योंकि किन्हीं athlete ऐसा है जैसे कि you can see in certain games, है ना, long distance का अलग होता है, weightlifters का अलग होता है, weightlifting वगैरह पे भी अपने opponents under the same weight category also, I mean उन लोग को अलग से assess करना होता है, है ना? जैसे कि किले का हाइट बेस से भी हम लोग प्रोपोर्शन कंसिडर करके हम लोग, तो ये डेटाबेस इज लाइक इन टर्म ऑफ रिसर्च एक्चुअली इट्स वेरी गुड, बट व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन इंडिविजुअली उसका देखना पड़ेगा हम लोग को, ना कि लाइक वी डोंट हैव टू पुल देम इन लाइक यू नो जैसे कि एक ग्रुप में.
Ma'am, here can I put any point?
Hello.
Ma'am, we can do one thing. We can go with the periodization, no? Like we can say to one target to them to reach and see how they are performing. Then we can proceed for the next stage. If it's not working good, then we can think for anything else. Like that it can be, no?
जो भी चीज actually like you know जो हम लोग athletes का जो assessment करते हैं, जो requirement करते हैं, वो long term base के लिए होता है, वो short term plan नहीं होता, ठीक है? And when we realize कि उसका athlete का वो जो होता है, ठीक है, उसकी जैसे कि competition phase पे कैसे है ना, उसकी periodization plan के हिसाब से भी हमें पता लगता है. But main thing is like observation is very important over the years. जैसे कि नहीं एक ही साल के अंदर तुम्हें सभी पता चले. You have to observe the athlete over a period of time also.
Yes.
Yeah, ma'am. At least we need to do longitudinal studies continuously now.
Excuse me, I think Tilak sir kuch matlab add karna chahte hain. Sir? Tilak sir? Hello? Sir?
Iska network connectivity sahi nahi hai kya?
Sir,
I'm Saju sir has also joined. Sir was saying something, but us samay network interrupt kar gaya tha.
Please wait.
Okay, okay. What can I was you saying is that what I was saying is that someone should do some kind of data digging from all these centers. They may be having all the data in their centers. So if you can work, you can get a lot of data from all the centers.
Sir, we will definitely do
sir,
that.
Sir, actually, I would like to add in on that one because I went through actually the database. So what happened is like one of the landmark which they took was wrong.
Where?
For body composition as well as for somatotyping.
In which center?
Sir, in Bangalore, the database that we have, because I've been through actually I've checked out those data. So that was before, like I came in actually to Bangalore.
Okay. So we have to catch the person who has done the data collection. Huh? Okay. Anyway, no, don't worry. Let's look into some other centers where the data was collected. If they have collected well, okay, then we could use that data. Okay. Another thing. Okay. Priyanka, I'm putting a hypothetical question to you. Okay. Hello, Priyanka?
Yeah, sir, I'm here.
Okay, let's say we have one athlete with upper body a bit muscular and lower body, quite slim and there is no muscle. So if you go, actually go to many gyms, you find that, okay, people build their pectorals and biceps and the muscles are quite huge upper extremity, but lower extremity they all look like pencil, so under which category you will classify this kind of athletes? I'm just giving you a particular example. Boxing, if boxers, if you look into upper extremity, they're quite muscular built, and relatively their biceps, deltoid, pectorals and all look quite okay, but then lower extremities, it's so under which category will they come?
For those kind of people, more muscle mass is present, so he definitely comes in mesomorphic category with mesomorphic category because his muscle. Amount of muscle or musculoskeletal robustness is high in his body, so he may be come in that category, mesomorphic category, because with high muscle he has built it in their upper part with exercise and training, sir.
Okay, so for let's say you found an athlete like this, okay, upper body, you have related a boxer, for example, a boxer. And how will you work with our strength and conditioning expert, whether you will still ask the SNC to build his lower extremity muscles or only what would be your suggestion?
Sir, it is actually on the basis of his performance. At present, present condition, the body type or muscle he or she may have, if he performs well, we need to measure it first. And if the performance is not up to mark, then SNC's and other who help them to increase or decrease their exercise or other training, help him or her to perform in that respective sports better, sir.
Okay. Well, I just put it as a hypothetical question only. Continue.
I think, sir, Tilak sir is wanted to add something. I think he raised.
Tilak
sir, Tilak, can you please, sir. Hello, sir.
सुनाई दे रहा है? हेलो,
हाँ सर सुनाई दे रहा
है। हाँ मैडम, एक क्वेश्चन पूछा था मैंने, पीक हाइट वेलोसिटी और पीक वेट वेलोसिटी और टैलेंट आइडेंटिफिकेशन में कुछ मदद करेगा कि नहीं करेगा? थोड़ा बहुत आप क्लैरिफाई करेंगे तो अच्छा रहेगा। मैम
तिलक सी स्टिक ऑन विद सोमाटो टाइपिंग हियर,
या
द अदर थिंग व्हेन दे विल डिस्कस।
I am in Bangalore Center and you are also in Bangalore Center, sir.
No, don't worry. See, the topic is on somatotyping. So let's go according to that topic. When it comes on, I think Dr. Atoni will take on peak height and velocity and all later on. So yeah, we'll discuss on that later.
Just had a doubt, sir. Probably like...
Okay. No worries. Yeah. Otherwise, what will happen? You know, we will be going out of the topic.
Yeah, done, sir. Okay, sir. Done. No problem.
Okay. Thank you. Anyone else?
Sir, there is a question in chat box that saying that could you please tell me how can we use in talent identification? So, from my part, first, you need to measure her body type, and according to that type, which type of sports is suitable, you have to identify it. And after his performance on specific of sports, you have to identify that person if he is suitable for that sports or not. Madam, are you there, ma'am?
Yes, Priyanka.
If you add something on that, ma'am.
See, actually, somatotyping, it can't be used for talent identification. We are just trying to create a profile, right?
Yeah.
So for talent identification, you need we need to check into various factors. First is the maturity status. Okay, because being an early mature and a late mature, also we have to take all this thing into consideration. And also for, like, as Tilak was mentioning about it, the onset of peak height velocity and peak weight velocity is also to be considered for all those things, as well as the body proportion. I think that's all. I wouldn't add.
Okay. Any other question? Dr. Ameya, is there anything you want to add? Dr. Ameya? Our new doctor is there, Dr. Rashid. Anything you want to add, Dr. Rashid?
Sir, there are some other anthropometrists from other centers. If they can contribute something.
Yeah, you can open the discussion to all other anthropometry people also.
Apriya, are you there from Guwahati Center? Apriya? Hello, Apriya. Hima from Delhi. Hello, Hima.
Hello, yes, Priyanka, can you hear me? Am I audible?
Yeah. Hello, Hima.
Yes, hello, so hello to everyone. So, yes, I would, I do not have actually anything to add because most of the things have been already discussed. And as far as about the talent identification, I'm just hoping and looking forward for a next session on talent identification. And about somatotype, I think most of the things have been already discussed. And if anything else is there, when we are actually dealing with the athletes, when we are assessing their performance, then we can have another session or like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Any other anthropometrists from any other centers?
Any coach want to ask any question? Oh, basketball coach, Bhaskar sir.
Sir, good afternoon. This is Bhaskar here.
Yes, sir.
yes, sir. As already I have put one question related to this talent identification. So they have already given me the answer. Thing is, we are using more anthropometrical measurements during the selection of our sports athletes for the induction of in STC and NCO, these ones. And it's sure now that we have to extend our things into taken into consideration of somatotype for the elite level athletes, because we are going to now handle the NCO. NCO is a what do you call the base for our Indian spokespersons. Another thing is, my question is, ma'am, since I am from basketball, what I felt that we are talking about the somatotype, when we are using the players, we have certain positions on the court. You know that in hockey, in handball or any team games, most of them, they used to play in various positions. So we can say, for example, I can say that near to the basket, the guy who is playing near to the basket may be some 2+10. 2 meters and 10 centimeters are 2.5 average. Whereas the point guard who is controlling the ball, maybe with a height of hardly 180 to 186 or even between 185 to 190. So how can we use this one? How can we say that this is the same type will for only for basketball? Because you have mentioned the, in your example also, the chart, it's basketball is how it is going to be. How can we...
sir, actually, I didn't get your point clearly, sir. You are asking about
ma'am, hamara hai basketball mein position is khel raha hai. Sabhi game ke taraf, team game mein har position ke upar ek ek player ka height weight mein change hota
hai. Priyanka can give info. Dr. Atoni also can come in and give feedback. Okay,
sir, from what actually I understand, जैसे कि आप बोल रहे हैं कि गेम की पोजीशन के हिसाब से अलग अलग होता है ना? जैसे कि आपके लिए somatotyping वो basically जो है वो एक profile create करता है body type के लिए. So what I would suggest is like you go for specific body proportions measurements such as the arm span. आपके लिए hand span also it's very very important. Okay, जैसे कि upper arm length और जैसे कि forearm का जो length है वो भी. And even the leg length also has to be considered in order to prevent injury actually. So, yeh sab cheeze, and then the foot length also has to be considered. Composition bhi important hai, iske alawa yeh bhi assess karna zaruri hai athletes ke liye. I have some data actually for basketball players actually. So I can share it with you.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Okay, thank you, that will be there. Thank you. Thank you, Saju sir. And Priyanka ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah, anyone else? If no other questions, I think then we can...
Sir,
Yeah, yeah, please.
Hello. Continue. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. Who is this?
Myself Atria from NCOE Guwahati. Sir, myself Atria from NCOE Guwahati. I'm an anthropometrist. Actually, I have a question to Priyanka, ma'am. Is it possible to have a cutoff in somatotype with respect to different ethnic population?
मैंने कभी ऐसा कुछ कट ऑफ ऐसा कभी देखा नहीं है. मतलब ये एक गुड थॉट है, लेकिन स्पोर्ट्स में देखिए इधर बहुत अलग अलग एथनिक पॉपुलेशन से यहाँ पर सब खेलने आते हैं. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर वो कट ऑफ यूज करना कितना यूजफुल होगा ये अभी मतलब आई डोंट नो. मतलब मेरा इस बारे में कोई जानकारी अभी नहीं है. मैम, इफ यू कैन ऐड एनीथिंग ऑन दैट, बिकॉज़ कट ऑफ के मामले में मैंने अभी तक कुछ नहीं सुना.
आई डिडंट गेट द क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली. वो क्या
मिस एडमिन्स, एक्चुअली आई वांट टू से दैट जस्ट एज फॉर हिप सर्कमफेरेंस, आई मीन वेस्ट हिप रेशियो, वी हैव अ जस्ट स्टैंडर्ड, वी हैव अ कट ऑफ फॉर मेल्स एंड फीमेल्स. सो is it possible to have a cutoff like this in somatotype with respect to different ethnic population? If we talk about the northeast population, if we talk about the western population, we are sure to get different somatotype.
I think there are a lot of research work based on population based studies, because even I think Monica is here, right? Monica has also done on population based studies, if I'm not mistaken. And Sukmani is also here.
Yes, ma'am. So,
yeah. So, काफी सारे देखो population based study, Indian population based study भी जो somatotype के base पे किया गया है, anthropometric somatotype पे, वो कम है लेकिन है already data.
Yes, they are. Yes, ma'am. There are certain studies which have been conducted on different populations. So body physique ke upar bhi hai and related to their like physical fitness ke aap associate kar sakte ho, and other anthropometric parameters also. So there are certain studies, but not for like specifically sports athletes ko leke it is difficult to find, but on ethnic population are many studies. So you can search it, you will find.
Okay, okay. And I have another, means just for my question. Hello. Actually, I have another query. It's not related to sports, but just for my information, is it possible to have somatotype done on pregnant women and elderly persons?
Somatotype on elderly people is okay, but somatotype on pregnant woman, I don't.
In the first place, how will you get a skin fold for supraspinale? You have to, I think that's a common sense thing.
Yeah.
Which, yeah.
For a pregnant woman, it is not giving you the right measurement during her pregnancy. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hello, you are not audible. Hello.
I think a lot of disturbance in net today. Dr. Tony, you can wind up then in that case.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah. Lot of disturbance.
Thank you, Priyanka madam. It was a wonderful session. Thank you.
Thank you, all of you, for your participation. Thank you, sir.
Document. Hello.
Ma'am, can we join up
the session?
Thank you.
Yeah, because we have a orientation program for from 4.
So,
can we leave?
Yes, for the other anthropometrists out here, so we'll be having an orientation session, right? So that time we can discuss
for those.
Okay.
Thank you all then for your participation, question, and discussion. Thank you, ma'am. Then I'm leaving. See you in the next session.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, all of you.
Allocation. Then. Thank you.